Hello. So good to meet you at this daily motivational meeting. We are reading quotes from the World Scripture Book. These quotes inspire and empower billions of people, families, communities, country, and the whole world. Just read them and practice. As we're reading the book from the beginning, please find all the chapters on our Message to Billions channel. And now we are reading about the greatest people in the history. And now let's read about Jesus, the Son of God and incarnation of the world. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Philip said to him, Lord, show us the Father, and we shall be satisfied. Jesus said to him, have I been with you so long, and yet you do not know me, Philip? He who has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father in me? Yet a little while, and the world will see me no more, but you will see me, because I live, you will live also. And that day you will know that I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. And this, the love of God was made manifest among us, that God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. And we have seen and testified that the Father has sent his Son as the Savior of the world. Whoever confesses that Jesus is the Son of God, God abides in him and he in God. So we know and believe the love God has for us. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God, as things were made through him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light of shines in the light and the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, yet the world knew him not. He came to his own home, and his own people received him not. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, full of grace and truth. We have beheld his glory, glory as the only Son from the Father. Father, let's read the quotes from the second coming Messiah. Father, Son, and Moon. After being born on this earth, Jesus claimed, I am the only begotten Son of God. He made the deceitful proclamation. No one came to the Father but by me, meaning that in history, up until his coming, no one could fully receive God's love. Thus, Jesus expounded the ultimate standard, the level that God longs to see us attain. Jesus was the only person who claimed this relationship with God. We read his words in John 14. Believe that I am the Father and the Father in me. Thus he declared that he is one with God. The Bible calls Jesus the only begotten Son. What does this mean? God's love is absolute love. Jesus was the first person in history who could receive the total love of God and represent that love to humankind. Because God gave Jesus the title Only Begotten Son, he could became our Savior. Jesus taught that he is in the true Son of God from the standpoint of love. Therefore, only by going through Jesus can we make a relationship of love with God. Among Jesus' words, he say, God is my Father. This is the correct teaching. It is the word that can bring complete success to human life. It is a word without precedent, which can elevate human affection to the level of heavenly heart and the heavenly law. Next, Jesus said, I am the bridegroom and you are the bride. He was speaking about this in a religious sense. Was he not in the human world? What can be more intimate than the relationship between husband and wife? What can be closer than the relationship between parent and child? Jesus also said that he was our brother. What the relationship could be closer? With these teachings, Jesus was describing God's family. He encapsulated the truth by describing relationship containing the divine heart. Jesus came as the incarnation of the Word. Jesus was the man whom God has been hoping to see over the long course of his restoration history. The desire of God from the time of creation. God's original thought in creating the universe centering on human beings was to rejoice with all his creation. This was God's desire, but it was not realized on this earth due to the fall of Adam and Eve, our progenitors. God created all existence in 6 days through the word, Logos. He bestowed upon all created beings the purpose to become God's object partner by manifest God's word. What then would all created beings hope for, having been created as substantial object partners through the word? This was for a mediator, one center being that would enable them to move in step with God. If human beings had become that center, the chaotic history that has unfolded on earth would not be have happened. God also hoped to see the appearance of the one being who could represent him and act on his behalf. This has been the center of God's hope, not only during the course of the providence of restoration since human fall, but even since the beginning of creation. The being God and creation hoped for would come as the significance, as the incarnation of the Word. Due to the fall of Adam and Eve, God's word returned to him without being manifested on earth. Meanwhile, separated from the world, human beings still live on this earth. Therefore, God will once again bestow his word upon humanity. Because Jesus was born on the foundation of a purified lineage, having nothing to do with Satan, he is indeed the Son of God. He could finally claim, I am the only begotten Son of God. No one like Jesus had ever appeared before in human history. There have been other religious founders and saviors in history, but no one of them was born relating to God as a son to his parent, because they did not have a purified lineage unstained by Satan's polluted blood. Neither Buddha nor Confucius nor Muhammad came from such a background. Therefore, God, Jesus God on earth was truly the hope of all humankind. It is through the glory of his person that we can receive new life and resurrection. So powerful quotes for today. If you have difficulties today, please watch one more time this video, share this video as we end this billion happy life subscribers marathon. contact me for consultation, cooperation, and became member of this global Heavenly Parents Holy Community. Wish you a great blessed day and see you tomorrow with more powerful quotes. Bye-bye. Yours, Nikolai Sirpale.